We will install a fan in this old refrigerator which is cooling but its performance is low. What do I mean by performance? I mean that it is consuming electricity more than normal. Now let me explain how this refrigerator is consuming more electricity. But first see this. This is the specification sticker from the manufacturing company of this refrigerator. Our 134A refrigerant is written on the sticker, which is added in this refrigerator. And 260 grams of refrigerant will be charged inside this refrigerator. But the problem is when I charge the refrigerator with 260 grams of refrigerant, the condenser of the refrigerator starts to overheat, which makes this refrigerator performance low. The ending pipe of the condenser should cool down, means the refrigerant should cool down. Due to this, its filter is also overheated, which makes this refrigerator performance low. The refrigerator is cooling but takes a lot of time, due to which the compressor will not stop and hence the electricity bill will be higher. So we will try to install this fan in such a way that its performance and efficiency will be increased and it would work as we bought a new refrigerator. When I had charged refrigerant in this refrigerator before filming this video, the refrigerator got choked. I removed all the pipes and cleaned them. Now I have charged only 200 grams of refrigerant. The cooling is fine, but the problem is the same, that it is taking a lot of time to cool. This refrigerator is a natural air cooled system. That's why we will try to cool it through the air using a fan. A myth is circulating that cooling the refrigerator compressor will increase the refrigerator performance. But actually the need is to cool down its condenser. The cooler the condenser, the performance and efficiency of the refrigerator will increase. We will use a DIY method to install this fan with the refrigerator to cool the condenser. The size of the fan is 120 by 120 by 38 millimeters. The voltage rating is 220 to 240 volts. It is 22 watts fan. So now I will install the fan with the condenser and with the ending pipe, where the refrigerant reaches lower temperature and turns into liquid so that the maximum cooler refrigerant should go inside the filter. I will install the fan on the condenser in such a way that the complete condenser should be cooled. The more the air will flow on the condenser, the more cooler it will. And thus, increases the refrigerator cooling performance. Now I have cut two pieces from the stainless steel sheet. One is bigger, and the other is smaller. I will fit both pieces with the fan properly. I have bent and fit the smaller one with the fan. Now I will install it in the center of the condenser. Now I will do its electrical connection so that the fan can work. I have made one connection with the relay, which is the neutral wire. The line wire I have attached with the overload passes through the thermostat. I already showed you how I installed the fan in this refrigerator. Now the fan is working perfectly fine. The refrigerator's performance has also increased. The 60 grams of refrigerant which were left I didn't charge in it. I will also charge the remaining refrigerant left. It is working for at least an hour, and its performance is really good now. Before the temperature of the filter was also high, as I was not able to touch the filter with my hands. But now the temperature of the filter is 31 degrees Celsius. The temperature of the compressor is also really good. Normally the compressor temperature should be between 50 to 70 degrees, but now the temperature is below 50 degrees as well. Now I have installed the thermostat with the compressor. The temperature of the compressor is 47.2 degrees right now. It is a good performance for the life of the compressor. If the compressor temperature rises to 70 degrees, then its behavior will be different. If the compressor keeps working at 47 degrees of temperature, then it would work for a lifetime. Now I will add the remaining 60 grams of refrigerant to this refrigerator, but gradually. First, I will add 20 grams of refrigerant. I will now add the remaining 40 grams, but we should take care of that. The suction pipe should not get overcooled. This is also a problem. So I will charge the refrigerant that much where its performance is the best. If 5 to 10 grams of gas is left to charge, then what the company has suggested, we will leave it. Now I will add 20 more grams of gas, as we added 15 grams in the previous clip. Now let's see how much gets added, because when I hold the manifold gauge in my hands, the weight machine does not show the precise measurement. Now 30 grams of refrigerant has been added inside the refrigerator. I have added the remaining refrigerant inside the refrigerator, off the camera. And the performance of the refrigerator is now 100%. The compressor is now heating up at 51 degrees Celsius. The room temperature right now is 28 degrees Celsius, and the compressor temperature could raise above 70 degrees Celsius at this temperature. But right now, it is normal. Now the performance of the refrigerator is 200%. The cooling inside the freezer is also great. The cooling from the starting pipe to the ending pipe of the evaporator is fine. The fridge cooling is also absolutely fine. And we can see ice on the fridge evaporator as well. Now the compressor will cut off quickly, which will decrease electricity consumption. And refrigerator performance is increased. This is for this video. I will catch you up in the next one. Click on the left or right thumbnail on the screen to watch more videos. And subscribe. It is free. Thank you.